hey there lads, my name is Lossy and welcome to Hell Let Loose, a new realistic World War II shooter being developed by Black Matter Studios. It's powered by the Unreal Engine, which, like most Unreal games, means it looks incredible. At its core, the game focuses on the all-out warfare of World War II, with a whopping player count of 100 individual people playing on a massive map. I've actually heard the map set in France, Saint-Marie-de-Mon, is pretty much a one-to-one scale to the actual location in Normandy. This makes Hell Let Loose way different to other World War II shooters, like Battlefield, for example. Battlefield games have always boasted very big maps, with all-out infantry and vehicle combat, but it feels different in Hell Let Loose. It feels like there are several battles going on all across this huge map. Another key feature of this game to take note of is that you aren't just fighting over flags. Each team has randomly chosen sectors to try and capture in sequence. Additionally, certain roles you can play, like officers and spotters, can construct garrisons and outposts that act as spawn points and depots. There is so much more to this game than a simple capture and defend mentality. Up top, you'll notice a few stats bars. These represent one of Hell Let Loose's biggest selling points, something that really drives home the realism of this game. It's all about the team's resources. There are three main ones: munitions, manpower, and fuel. Munitions are always something to consider. It's like Battlefield 5's attrition on steroids. Every bullet counts, and if you and your team waste them, well, you'll be in trouble. The manpower is nothing new, it's simply the number of respawns your team has. And fuel applies to vehicle spawns like tanks. If you don't have enough fuel, you won't be able to spawn a Tiger as backup to take an objective. It all comes together to make you feel like you're actually part of a much bigger team. It's not okay to just respawn when you're out of ammo, because you're actually damaging your team's chances of winning the match. It doesn't quite restrict the lone wolf mentality either though, it just makes you want to work together. Speaking of working together, the 100 player count is broken up into units. In-game, the unit refers to a collection of soldiers that fall under three headings: infantry, armor, and recon. There's also a commander who's tasked with directing the battle. They are essentially the leader of your team and someone that uses the vast communication channels to tell the different units what to do. Along with the commander, there are 13 other roles to choose. The officer, the machine gunner, the anti-tank, there's really a role for every kind of playstyle. There's so much to learn and get your head around with Hell Let Loose. I was lost initially, I didn't understand what was happening, and only just now figured out things because of how detailed the tips are on the main menu, and even then I'm still learning the ropes. It's a game that I really didn't think I'd enjoy this much. The gunplay is along the lines of Insurgency, but not quite as brutal. But then again, that could just be because Insurgency is all about the automatic weapons of modern times. Hell Let Loose has plenty of familiar features and mechanics from the Battlefield franchise too. The crouch, sprint, along with the self-heal pack are all present. Some of the same weapons are usable too, which obviously makes sense, you know, considering they're set in the same time and conflict. I just feel like Hell Let Loose plays more like a World War II shooter for me. I know Battlefield 5 is all about those untold stories, which is great, but sometimes people just want to play using those iconic weapons of the Second World War, fighting in those iconic locations like Normandy. Comparing the two isn't fair though, they're both very different games that can definitely coexist. But it does make me wonder what the reception to Battlefield would have been like if it played more into what people expected. But anyway. Share your thoughts on the game, what you think it looks like, and check out my Twitter page for two codes on the game. It also includes the full game releasing on the 6th of June. I'll leave that date with you. Let me know in the comments if you figure that out. If you enjoyed the video, leave it a like, I'd really appreciate that, or a dislike if you didn't. Subscribe to join the lads, but until the next one, I'll see you lads later.